This video about logistics is sponsored by World of Tanks, yet more on this later. In this video, we mostly deal with the supply side of logistics, since the Tiger repair video already covered maintenance, which is also a key element of logistics if you take the military definition. Be aware that Tiger logistics isn't the best studied topic. Luckily, I found very interesting reports from 1943 in the archives. So, the Panzerkampfwagen VI Ausführung E, also known as the Tiger, was a heavy tank. As you can imagine, taking care of such a big cat and keeping it purring properly can be quite demanding. So initially, let us look at some numbers. First, fuel consumption. The Tiger had a fuel capacity of 530, 534 or 540 liters, depending on who you ask. Since Spielberger gives the number 534 and refers to regulation with number and date, I suspect it is the correct one. If we look at the fuel consumption for 100 km, it of course depended on the situation, yet here the numbers differ even more widely. First, according to Jentz Doyle, referring to German army test data from late 1943, 450 liters for 100 km on the road and 650 liters for 100 km on average terrain. Whereas the Haynes manual written by the members of the tank museum at Bovington have far better numbers. For 1944, referring to data from the company Henschel, they note 100 km on road would require only 270 liters, which would mean a range of 200 km on the road, whereas for 100 km on average terrain, only 480 liters are noted, which is almost the same number that the German army in late 1943 determined for 100 km on the road. These numbers are likely that low since they are mostly theoretical. For instance, you don't sit around idling your engine and everything is in perfect running order. Furthermore, there might also have been some improvements made by Henschel over the time. The problem is, according to a British wartime report, the numbers were even far worse and surprised the also known German values, which also don't match up with any of the other values given before. Anyway, here the British report on Tiger 131. Entries show that 4,197 liters of petrol went into the fuel tanks of this vehicle during a period in which 489 kilometers were covered. In other words, the apparent petrol consumption was over 10 liters per kilometer. Even if it is assumed that the tank's total capacity, 530 liters, were empty at the start and full at the finish, the consumption would still work out at about 9 liters per kilometer. These figures are higher than the petrol consumption quoted in the official German specs. Roads, 5.4 liters per kilometer, 1.58 gallons per mile. Cross country, 7.8 liters per kilometer, or 2.76 gallons per mile. These numbers are far higher than the previous ones. There might be several reasons for this, assuming these numbers are correct. First, this Tiger saw action. On marches, before, during and after combat, there are often times when the engine is running, but not necessarily is the tank moving. Second, this was an early Tiger, as such both the vehicle crews and the maintenance crews had less experience. Third, towing other Tigers was likely more common for recovery purposes as well, which burned more fuel at a shorter distance. Fourth, the engine of Tiger 131 was a HL210P45, not the HL230P45. Like from the previous report. Now it seems the differences between these engines were minor, but Jentz and Doyle note that starting in November 1943, which is the date of the reference value they give, the governor was preset at the factory for a maximum speed of 2500 RPM under full load, and the motors were outfitted with a hand-operated temperature control on the oil cooler. Whereas the British report on Tiger 131 notes a maximum RPM of 3000. And usually engines burn the most at high RPMs. As such, the fuel efficiency was likely highly improved by a reduction to 2500 RPM. Finally, we also have another German value, namely that from the Tiger Fibel, the Tiger primer, which notes, with 1 liter in the fuel tank you can drive 200 meters, which means 5 liters per 1 kilometer and thus 500 liters per 100 kilometer. Ah yes, the choice of having as many sources as the Germans had front lines. Well, let us take the most two extreme values, namely those from the British wartime report and that's from the tank museum referring to the production company, which would mean 9 to 10 liters per kilometer at the maximum versus 2.5 liters per kilometer on the road and 4.8 liters per kilometer on average terrain as the minimum. To put this in contrast with data from the Panzer IV Ausführung H, there we have values from production data sheets from 1943. They are 2 liters for 1 kilometer on the road, 3.3 liters for 1 kilometer on average terrain. And for the sake of my sanity and brevity of this video, I refrain from looking at any other source on the Panzer IV fuel consumption, by the way. Of course, what is more interesting, how much fuel was actually needed by a Tiger unit during operations. For the 503rd Heavy Tank Battalion, we have some numbers on fuel consumption for 9 months. In total, about 1.5 million liters of gas were transported and another 250,000 of diesel fuel. This was most likely for the varying supporting vehicles. According to the report, this almost amounts to 90 tank rail cars filled with fuel. So this Tiger Battalion needed on average about 9 tank railway cars of fuel each month. Yet our cats also needed some oil to run smoothly. Here we go with the Tiger Fibel, which pointed out, morale, the engine burns if you don't grease it, and it burns up if you lose the oil. Note in German the engine is referred as he, and the oil is it, so the direct translation doesn't work here. Furthermore, it gives specific instructions which 6 areas had to be filled with how much oil, namely the engine with 28 liters of engine oil, the change speed gearbox with 30 liters of transmission oil, the right and left final drive, each with 6 liters of transmission oil. For the turret, another 5 liters of transmission oil were required. And finally, the ventilation system also required 7 liters of transmission oil. So in total, 82 liters of oil. Sadly, I could not find any numbers in terms of consumption per time or distance. Now in terms of ammo, the full loadout of a regular Tiger was 92 shells. Sadly, I haven't found anything for ammo consumption so far. Luckily, the Tiger Fibel includes some notes about the interdependence of ammo and logistics, which are quite interesting. For every shell you fire, your father paid 100 Reichsmarks in taxes. Your mother worked at the factory for a week. The railroad has traveled 10,000 kilometers. Think about that before you fire a shot. It continues. Firing explosive shells on unrecognized targets on suspicion, on targets that can be killed with machine guns, is a crime. Armor-piercing shells fired at useless distances, at destroyed tanks, or are poorly aimed, only give a notch carving in steel. When it comes to spare parts, it gets quite interesting. The 503rd Heavy Tank Battalion used up a total of 275,919 kg of spare parts in a time frame from 5th July to 30th of September 1943, so a bit less than 90 days. Yet a closer look at the statistics actually reveals that this number also includes return transmission and engines, which accounted for a total weight of 72,000 kg. As such, the correct number would be 203,673 kg, if I understood that correctly. So this is roughly 204 tons, and since the authorized strength for a battalion was 45 Tigers, this would mean about 4.5 tons of spare parts for each Tiger we used, or a bit less than 8% of its combat weight of 57 tons in a duration of a bit less than 90 days, or about 50 kg in spare parts each day. They were big cats after all. The unit also had a complete list of spare parts and their weight for the period. By far the most important part in number and weight were the track wheels, with a total of 813 pieces, which in terms of weight was 64,215 kg. Additionally, the report marked which spare parts were available in large enough numbers in the spare parts depot and which ones had to be ordered directly from the Reich or salvaged from other tanks. According to the information, the biggest issue with availability here was the drive sprockets, with 32 pieces for 13,120 kg. Now, most Tiger units were organized in independent heavy tank battalions, schwere Panzer-Abteilungen. These were attached to various formations during the course of the war, yet exactly this sometimes created some problems, as Schneider notes. The sometimes alarmingly poor cooperation with logistics staff at higher levels was a regular problem. In principle, the subordination of a heavy tank battalion to a large formation was coupled with the binding obligation to supply. In reality, however, friction often occurred because the new overall responsible person preferred his own formations, or because the suddenly much higher required supply quantity was not available. This is very similar to something Nicolas Moran once mentioned during a video interview when his tank unit was assigned to another unit that initially the unit's leadership was quite surprised by how much the tanks consumed. Yet back to summer 1943. Here, the 503rd Heavy Tank Battalion found an interesting solution for the spare parts situation. In order to optimize the allocation of spare parts, they requested to send one of their spare part clerks directly to the Heereszeugamt, meaning the Armour Ordnance Depot in Magdeburg. To quote from the report, "The Heavy Tank Battalion was fully supported by the Superior Office and received the approval of the Army High Command to have such a representative of its interest in Magdeburg. After a few days, he was able to announce that the spare parts requested by the battalion were being transported by lightning arrow transport," this is the literal translation by the way, "in wagons intended only for the battalion. The repair of damaged parts was accelerated extraordinarily by this unique speed of delivery of spare parts." Of course, this raises several questions. First, was this a special case due to the special circumstances or due to personal connections? Second, was this a special case since this was one of the earlier heavy tank battalions? Third, if any of these were the case, did it have an influence on the future allocation of spare parts, special clerks, priority shipping and other practices? The report also notes how the regular delivery would take on average about 6 weeks. The previous supply of spare parts on request via Panzer Spare Parts Warehouse B lasts 6 weeks on average, where information about the expected spare parts could not be given or was rejected in principle. This means that the troops are deprived of any possibility of making appropriate arrangements in the current mobile warfare in the East. The report continues that the troops think that the best approach is not to use intermediary spare part depots and that spare parts should be delivered directly from Magdeburg to the front line, ideally with troop trains or other high priority train transports. And speaking of priority treatment, a word from our sponsor of this episode, the free-to-play game World of Tanks, which made this video possible in the first place. Now if you want to get started with World of Tanks, they provide a special invite link for new players that is linked at the top of the description. This link gives you immediate access to a Tier 5 Premium Matilda Black Prince, 7 days of premium time, 1 garage slot and a 100% trained crew. You might ask, what about the Tiger? Well, you also get 2 rental tanks for 10 battles each, namely the famous Tiger 131 of the Tank Museum at Bovington, which once roamed the North African desert. And since you also might want to go tiger hunting, the second rental tank is the British Sherman Firefly. So if you want to ambush one or more of the million players worldwide, head on in. Of course, you can also charge in and deal it out up close and personal, since World of Tanks allows for many different playstyles. Yet, we are not done yet. This year there's a virtual Tank Fest, which means there's an online stream as well. It is also linked in the description. Big thank you here to World of Tanks for sponsoring this episode. Be sure to check out the link in the description. As always, sources are listed in the description. Thank you for watching and see you next time.